frisky, fresco frieze that still is of the original one. You can see lots of Renaissance portraits all around you with all the faces of the greatest and best anatomists in the world. And so, obviously, all the best doctors in the world want to come here in Palazzo City because they could study here in very in such a free and independent way. So that's why the best medical discoveries were made here. Maybe you know Harvey. Harvey was an English medical student. He discovered here in Palazzo City circulation of blood. Circulation of blood was discovered here. Morgagni was the first anatomical pathologist in the world. He taught here for 60 years. Vesalius, the one on the top, from it was Flemish. He was the first anatomist in the world to publish an illustrated anatomical book in 1542. Fallopio is the one of Fallopio's few amateurs, you know. He started here and taught here. So, I'm really the best anatomist in the world. And then, last information about the work, that big fresco that you can see there and was made in 1942. So, this is another example of fascist artworks. And it's really interesting because we know that the artist there was Funi, Achille Funi, futurist artist, really famous in Italy, really important. And the rector asked him to paint something about medicine. Okay, so that's why you can see all those bodies, human bodies, painted on that. But the artist even knew that rector was an archaeology teacher. And so, just to be well paid, he decided to paint even classical sculptures, no? Something referred to archaeology. So, this is a typical example of what happened between art and politics at that time, huh? Yeah. Well, now, tell me, there's another last statue. So she was really famous and well-known in the city. And then she asked to be the first woman to graduate. But she asked to graduate in theology. And as you can maybe understand, maybe imagine, it was not that easy because she was a woman. So university approved, but then the bishop of the city opposed, telling that no women could study theology. So the bishop opposed, and then after many years, they could finally find a compromise. Elena Lucrezia could graduate, but in philosophy, not in theology, as she wanted at the beginning. But then, accepting this special compromise, she could be the first woman in the world to graduate, so luckily for us. 1678. So she was like a pioneer. 1678. Okay, now we have finished. We are in the round four back again. So I will open this cage, this gate. You can come here with me. Okay, so thank you very much. Hope you enjoy it. You understood me quite good. Thank you very much and have a nice day.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Thank you very much.
Bye bye.